Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, it's not what it looks like. Part one of two parts. And they took Joseph's coat and killed a kid of the goats and dipped the coat in the blood. And they sent the coat of many colors and they brought it to their father and said, this we have found. Know now whether it be thy son's coat or no. And he knew it and said, it is my son's coat. And evil beasts had devoured him. Joseph is without doubt rent in pieces. And Jacob rent his clothes and put sackcloth upon his loins and mourned for his son many days. Genesis 37, 31 through 34. Satan is the master illusionist. Before David Copperfield, before David Blaine, and before Chris Angel, there was Lucifer. Illusionists major in the art of optical illusion. They divert your attention away from what is really happening, getting you so distracted so that they can implement their own smoke and mirror tricks. And when you look back at what you thought was real, it appears to be something different altogether. And that's what Satan specializes in, making something that's not real appear real, making you think something is there that is not really there. Satan first appears in the book of Genesis as a serpent. By the time we read Peter's writings, he appears as a roaring lion. And by the end of the Bible, he has become a dragon. How did this happen? Lamentation 1 verse 9 says, O Lord, behold my affliction, for my enemy had magnified himself. No, magnify doesn't mean to make anything bigger. It literally means to cause to appear greater or seem more important. That is in fact the case. I want to take a few minutes just to lay the foundation here and make you understand that Satan has no real power over the child of God. He only has the ability to intimidate us with false illusions. The main weapon in the enemy's arsenal is deception. Satan deals in fear, which someone said was an acronym for false evidence appearing real. In fact, that's his only weapon, since he has no real power over the child of God. Colossians 2 verse 15 says, having spoiled the principalities and powers, Luke 10 verse 19 reminds us that behold, I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Satan has no power over us other than what we grant him. He has no authority over us other than what we surrender to him. He has no way to hurt us or destroy us. But his goal is to make us destroy ourselves. And his goal is to take something that is not real and convince you that it's real and cause you to act on false assumption. If Satan can cause you to believe a lie, you will destroy yourself. You will give up on your hopes, your dreams, your vision, your promise from God. You will walk away grieving, never realizing that you're acting on a lie. And that's exactly what happened in the case of Jacob. Joseph's brothers had thrown him in the pit and sold him into slavery and essentially rid themselves of the problem of having a younger brother that was more highly favored than them. But one problem remains. What are they going to tell their father? Notice their tactics. They dipped their brother's distinctive coat into the blood of an animal and brought it back to their father. And notice what they said. Here is the coat we found. We don't know if it's thy son or not. And notice Jacob's response. And he knew it and said, it is my son's coat. And evil beasts had devoured him. Joseph is without doubt rent into pieces. Notice here the power of optical illusion. The enemies of Jacob, which is in this case his sons, came and presented false evidence appearing real. And Jacob made his own assumptions. The evidence was incorrect, but it was real enough to Jacob to make him respond with defeat and rent his clothes and mourn his son. But if someone had gotten to Jacob, they would have told him, Jacob, it's not what it looks like. Your promise is not dead. It is in the process of being fulfilled so that your life can be saved later. Your dream is not over. It's just beginning. What God has promised you is not dead. It's alive. And it's in the process of bringing about a victory that you can't even imagine. Don't let your enemy let you jump to conclusions. Stand on the promise God has given you. It's not over. It's not what it looks like. It's false evidence appearing real. But God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. The thought of the day: your dream is not over. It's just beginning. God bless you today. In Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle walker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.